show. You guys weren't invited to that. Welcome to the auditions for my show. So I just want to go over a few things first. So, first things first, no flash photography. You guys can record, but no flashlight things on your phones. Please try to remain as respectful as possible to everybody on stage. No coughing. No, I'm just kidding. If you want to eat, just make sure you're quiet and the person in front of you is eating something super loud, just punch you in the back of the head and it'll be okay. enough talk, let's just get this thing started. Carter! Get out here, man!
What? Okay, where do you want these?
Put them down stage right.
Right here?
Is that down stage right, Carter?
No. Okay, I'm nervous. You want to come on the edge of the stage?
Yeah, it's fine. Just come on, let's go. You alright? You okay?
Can we just get the show started?
Yeah. Pretty good.
Get out of here, everybody!
Alright, first off, I want to thank you all for coming out here today. My name is Mr. Torrance. Yes?
Can I go to the bathroom?
Okay, just hold on.
Excuse me, my mommy's going to be up in half an hour and I need to go first.
Can you guys just shut up?
Look, I know I'm new here, but I want to talk to you guys a little bit about this theater program. You guys might go to some other schools around here and see some pretty good shows. They do a fine job. We don't do a fine job here. We do an amazing job. So if you're going to be in my show, you're going to have to be amazing. So what I'm looking for here today are the best of the best. You understand?
So I can't go to the bathroom?
No!
Okay, look. This is Carter. He's my stage manager. It goes from God to me to Carter to all of you. You will listen to him as if you were me. You got a problem with scheduling, you talk to Carter. You're going to be late to rehearsal, you talk to Carter later. This is the first audition. I'm going to call back a few of you. From those that best get to be in my show, you have 3 minutes to prepare yourself. Go ahead, get that.
Carter, first. Look, like we have a cast. singing?
My mom's waiting for me in the parking lot.
Great. What are you going to sing?
Wait. I have to sing.
This is a musical.
This is a musical?
Didn't you see the posters?
Wait. There were posters?
Didn't you listen to the announcements?
I can't ever hear the announcements. No one ever shuts up for them.
So, let me get this straight. You don't have a song prepared.
We were supposed to
have
Yes!
No, I don't have a song.
Alright, how about Happy Birthday?
Are you sure I have to sing?
Can you even sing Happy Birthday?
Are there any non-singing parts?
Well, we're gonna have to hear you sing first before I can put you in a non-singing part.
But that doesn't make any sense.
He just needs to know if you can't sing.
Oh, okay. Happy Birthday, right? Funny thing, I forgot the word.
It starts with Happy Birthday.
Hello? Oh, okay. I'll be right there. I'm so sorry. I have to go. When are the facts?
Now this next person we have up in
the house. Hi, I'm Emma. And I just got a dance. Kick it. Sorry. And I just got a dance. Kick it.
You know when I say, I just gotta dance, kick it, that means I need some music, right?
You didn't bring any music.
I don't care if I didn't bring music. I'm determined to get this role. Something happened. Something has to happen.
Look,
please.
That is nice and all, but you didn't bring any music, so something can happen.
Can you hum something? Anything can happen, please. Anything.
Hate my job.
Thank you.
I'll beatbox some.
Thank you. And I just gotta dance. Kick it!
Dance with some rope.
What's your name? Karen's photo. Karen.
Carter.
Carter. Carter, that sucks. You know what? It's gonna have to do. Okay. You ready? You ready?
I'm ready.
I just gotta dance. Kick it! And I do some robot, oh yeah, and I do some crab and some school spirit, right? Yeah, let's go. Some of this disco, man, because my mom told me it was cool. Woo! Oh, yeah, what's up? How was that?
You know what?
There was.
I'm not really sure about some style of dance we're looking for here.
Style? You want to change up the style a little bit?
I know.
I'll give you a 180 change of style. Ballet, let's do some ballet. Ballet, woo! Ballet! And plies. And woo, and this, and this, and that, and some jumps, and some jumps, and I'm dizzy, and... Oh my god.
Are you serious?
I'm very serious. Style, though, you're not very impressed, are you? Let's do some tango, man.
What?
Tango, here you go. Hey, music, man, let's go. Tango.
Callbacks will be posted tonight.
Yes! Let's go.
You better leave.
Okay.
Most things, like if you want to be like mean, aggressive, right? I could do that. If you wanted like funny or flirty, I could do that. And if you wanted me to do a sad role, I practice about every day. No, it's like I do it in like preparation because I always just practice to cry. I practice crying. Regularly, I practice. Because it's not like that. It's like, you know, you never know when you'll need it. like, because I'll just sit in my room sometime.
Hi there, I'm Alex.
bass. Of course you know that. Let's see, experience? Last year I was Anna in Anna and the King. The year before that I was Belle in Beauty and the Beast. And the year before that I was the Crucible in The Crucible. Well, okay, I wasn't The Crucible. That's not really a role, but if there was a role for The Crucible, that would be me. And when I was a little kid, I played Annie in Annie.
Wow. Real impressive, Alice.
I know, isn't it? That was a joke. Look, do I really have to audition? I mean, who are we trying to fool here, right? I know when everyone's here, you can't make it look like you're gonna give a part to a certain person, but come on, we both know what's going to happen. Does that make me sound conceited?
can I audition with somebody else? Is that possible?
How many do you have to hear you sing first?
Okay, but for the acting, can I bring in a partner?
Sure.
Could my partner be Tommy?
Yes.
You don't know how much that means to me.
Carter.
And?
Can you join the Tommy?
Hi.
and can I tell you a little something? Tommy doesn't really know he's going to be doing it with me.
Oh.
But that's okay. I mean, it's also fine if we do this whole scene right now.
Well, I was thinking maybe we could.
Carter!
What's going on?
Looks like they're pairing us up for a duet scene.
What duet scene?
Oh, they're thinking about adding it. Yeah, here's the script.
Is this even going to be in the show?
Yeah, like I said, I think they're going to add it. And I overheard them talking earlier. They want passion.
Passion?
Right, passion.
Okay.
You can do this. Are you ready?
But I haven't even read
the... Hi, my name is Sara Arlen. This is Tommy Hartley, and we are going to be auditioning for you now.
I don't know if I love Anne anymore.
How can you say that?
I think there's somebody else that I love more.
Oh, Gregory, don't. Please. You can't mean me.
I do. You see, Anne is fat, and wears too much makeup around her eyes. It makes her look like a pig ran through the department store. Also, I hate her high, whining voice. It's like whenever she starts talking, all the dogs in the neighborhood come running. She smells like bacon all the time. Why did I ever go out with her?
Oh, you were crazy!
I was, but now it's you.
You do?
Yes. Compared to you, my current girlfriend is a bloated, dead octopus. I'm sure you already have the Nuremberg needles left over by the mafia. But you?
Yes.
You are the most beautiful girl in the world. You are a star. A diamond. A diamond star. The cherry on my sundae. The whipped cream in my hot chocolate. The teeth in my mouth. I kiss you, and not just like a regular kiss, a super kiss. The kind of kiss looks like you've been hit in the head with a brick of love and is bleeding out of the side of your head. With that brick and all the blood that's oozing down your hair.
Oh my God.
Just like that.
Kiss me then, you sad, wonderful fool! Oh, it says you're supposed to kiss me right here. You're supposed to kiss me to get the part. Passion!
Okay.
Police.
So what do you mean you can't remember happy birthday?
Happy birthday.
I thought it was
you.
Navidad.
Why
did
she leave?
Navidad.
Wait, she left. How'd she come back? How'd she come back?
My life. My carry.
So, what are you doing this time?
I'm practicing.
What?
There's a musical at school.
Oh.
I'm auditioning for it.
Can you go practice that somewhere else? I'm trying to watch TV.
Well, don't you want to know what the show is?
I'm sure it's fine. Fine, what's the show?
A Chorus Line.
Okay.
It won the Pulitzer Prize.
Oh, I'm sure it did.
Are you feeling okay?
No. I had a long day at work. I just want to sit here and watch TV. Is that okay with you?
Are you hungry? Do you want me to make something to eat?
Nope.
Can I make myself something to eat?
You know what, Carrie? Do whatever you want. Just quit bothering me.
Okay. My life by Carrie. My life is the most wonderful thing. When I was 10, I got cast in the school play. Our school was doing a play our teacher wrote about Winnie the Pooh, and I was Tigger, probably because I was pretty paper. I was so excited. I learned all my lines within the first week. And every night at home, I'd practice my song about how Tiggers were made of rubber and everything. Our school didn't have a lot of money, but my friend's mom made me a costume, and I felt really good about it. I mean, I felt amazing. It was like my whole life. I was looking for something I was good at. And then all of a sudden, here it was. I was good at being Tigger. I couldn't run fast. I couldn't do math. I couldn't even spell. But when I sang that Tigger song, I was proud. So the day of the show came, and I was backstage in my Tigger costume. And I was really nervous. I had to pee like every 5 minutes. And then I went out there on stage, and the lights were really bright. And I could see the outline of all the heads out there. And I could hear them. And I did my song, and I just put everything I had into it. And I wasn't nervous anymore. I was really happy. And then when I finished, the whole audience applauded for me. For me. I'd never been applauded for anything in my whole life. And after the show, all the parents came up hugging their kids. Even the kids who played trees. I remember this one dad came up and he was like, "You were the most realistic tree of them all." And everyone was there. And everyone was getting hugged. And there were these flowers. And I looked around for my dad. And I kept looking for him. And I kept looking. Then everyone started to go home. And I was still there. And I was still in that stupid Tigger costume. I asked him later why he didn't come to the show, and he said, "What show?" I was pretty good, too.
Ah,
She wants to know that any non-speaking roles. Okay, next up we have a girl. Her name is Soleil.
It's Soleil.
With a Y spelled Soleil.
It's French. It means the sun.
Your name is the sun?
Actually, I was named after the girl who played Cookie Rooster. Soleil means fry.
Oh, what?
Punky Brewster. Do you know that show?
No, and you're weird.
That's what people have been telling me.
Have you seen that girl?
What a freak.
Who wears that?
Does she do that to her clothes herself?
She's like just sitting there reading a book.
What is wrong with her?
Do you think she's on drugs?
She's totally on drugs.
You think you're special or something?
Why do you look like that?
Why do you talk like that?
Why do you think like that?
No one likes you. All the time you see these girls
walking in here like they own everything.
Like nothing applies to them.
So weird.
Head in your book.
Eyes down.
Don't you care what people think of you?
Did you take a shower this morning?
You're nothing.
You're nothing.
You're nothing.
You're nothing.
I can do this. I can be here. The world takes people like you and shoots them up.
You can't.
I can be in the show.
You're a shadow.
You're a nightmare.
You're the thing we left behind.
I wish I could be like you.
Shh. Don't you know the world belongs to us?
To the pretty,
the popular,
the rich.
Don't you know we're happier than you?
I'm not happy though.
Shh. I'm plenty happy. You're a freak.
Disease.
Emo.
You're the depressed little doll we left in the corner.
I'm not like you.
Of course you're not.
I'm not like you.
You wish you were. You wish you were.
No, I don't.
You wish you were.
I wish I was like you.
That's all we wanted to hear.
I grew up alone. My dad left us. My mom didn't make it. And I was alone.
Ugly.
And I'd look at the girls who were pretty, and the girls who were thin, and the girls who seemed to know everything. They knew everything about clothes and money and music and what to say and how to act, and they were so beautiful. And I looked at myself in the mirror, and I wasn't like them. I wasn't like them.
No.
I was something ugly, something diseased, something to be laughed at and hated and destroyed because I existed. Just because I existed, I was wrong, and they were so easy. Life was so easy for them as they got in their cars, their mothers on the way home, and I was on the bus. I was alone on the bus, and I'd always sit up front next to the bus driver, put my bag next to me on the seat. And there was this boy who'd sit behind me, and he said I was the garbage man.
Hey there, garbage can.
And they'd throw garbage at me, and he'd flick my ears. And every day at recess, I never wanted to go outside. I prayed for rain every single day. And I never wanted to go outside because I had no one at all. No one at all near me.
Garbage can.
No one liked me. No one to talk to. And I just hoped the other kids would leave me alone and let me read a book. Most days, they just did. But sometimes, they'd kick the kickball and they'd back me up against the wall. I'd stand there with my head against the wall, and they'd throw it at me again and again, and every once in a while a girl would come up and shove my head against the wall or put mud in my hair, and the teachers watched. They thought we were just playing. And after that, I went home alone, cried on the way home, and then I cried at night for my mom, who died when I was 6, and after that, I just wanted her to come back because they stared all the time. They just stared.
You're different. You're weird. You're ugly. You're poor. Sleep on dirt. Take a shower today. Why don't you just leave?
But I didn't. Sorry to disappoint you. And I stopped wishing I was like them. And I stopped caring what they said.
You're weird. You're ugly. You're poor. You're stupid.
I'm not. I'm going to be better than all of you. And when I got here, when I got to high school, I found this. Suddenly, it wasn't all that bad to be different. It wasn't all that awful to be weird. And I'm happy. And
And if someone were to offer me tomorrow, if I trained it all to be average just like them, to be pretty and simple, not think too much, have boys fall in love with me and write me notes, to go to the movies with my friends on the weekends, if someone were to offer me that trade, do you know what I'd say? Yes, in a heartbeat. Nor women neither, though by your smiling, you do seem to say so.